is that he has friends who are not Muslims, and they always ask him, do Jews and Christians go to hell even if they are good? He reversed the question to them. Go to a Christian and ask him, if I, Asim al-Hakim, go to the Pope in Rome, in the Vatican, and I say, Padre or Father or whatever, I'm as a Muslim who do not believe in Jesus to be my Savior, peace be upon him, and I do not believe him to be the Son of God. Will I enter heaven or hell? He'll say, definitely, my son, you will go to hell. Okay, if I go to Krishna, or if I go to a rabbi, or if I go, well, rabbi is definitely, all the Jews say, anyone else who is not a Jew is in hell. So this is the norm. Every religion says this, because you cannot find a religion saying that, listen, if you follow my beliefs and religion, you go to paradise. And if you follow any belief and religion, you go to paradise. Paradise is not a public place. You have to have a visa, you have to have specifications, you have to have conditions for you to enter it. Now, as Muslims, these conditions are not based on race, it's not based on color, it's not based on social status like other religions. It's based on your conviction and belief. Believe in the oneness of Allah, the Almighty, who has no associates, who has no partners, who does not beget and is not begotten, who does not have a wife, who does not have a child. Believe in the oneness of Allah and the greatness of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and believe that this servant and messenger of his, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the one who was sent as a mercy to the worlds. That is it. You become a Muslim and you'll be saved. Ah, but then people say, no, we don't want this. We want to abide by our beliefs and yet still enter Jannah. Ya akhi, enter it. If you can, enter it. It's not mine. I don't have the keys for it. So you don't have to sugarcoat it to these people, say, yeah, be good and maybe. No. If you do not believe in the oneness of Allah, this is what we call the testimony, the shahada, the kalima, and that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his servant and messenger, if you do not believe in this, you're not a Muslim. If you do not believe that the Quran is the final revelation, you're not a Muslim. If you believe that there is another messenger coming after the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as some cults and sects believe, you're not a Muslim. And hence, you will not enter paradise. So I hope this answers your question. Now, he has a